Imagine being able to end disease with a snip to your DNA. In fact, it's happening right now, and Kiwi scientists are at the cutting edge. The world's first CRISPR human gene editing trial in Auckland could delete diseases passed down through generations. It's not without its detractors, but as Mark Kreisel discovers, for families facing down the abyss of horrific disease, now there's real hope.
The toll of carrying an incurable hereditary disease isn't just knowing it's going to kill you, it's knowing you could pass it on to your children.
You feel responsible, even though, you know, it's not your fault that you carry the gene. But you do feel like you've given them this thing that can make them very sick and can kill them.
No, like sleeping.
It impacts them mentally and emotionally, impacts their future, who they're going to be with, and it's not something that you would, any parent would wish upon their kids.
There's a strong chance the DNA inside these women's children contains a deadly gene. But this may not be the end of their story.
Did you ever, in your wildest imagination, think this would be possible?
Well, not in my lifetime.
Look at photos of Aubrey Christmas, and one thing stands out.
He had a beautiful smile.
He does have a beautiful smile, yeah, and that's the smile that got me when I first met him on the plane.
Jamie and Aubrey had four kids and were married for 26 happy years. But the whole time, he was carrying a genetic time bomb.
I was with him. We were sitting in the clinic next to each other, and he was told that the test came back positive. It was just silence.
In 2013, Aubrey was diagnosed with hereditary amyloidosis. He was 49.
I didn't know what to say. I just didn't know what to say.
There was no cure. Nine of Aubrey's family members in this photo, including his mother, grandmother, and brother, had all died early from amyloidosis.
You truly believed it wasn't going to touch you?
We both truly did, you know, and maybe in the stillness of the night, probably there's a prayer that goes out, please, you know, especially when you have children.
Hereditary amyloidosis is a rare genetic disease which causes liver cells to produce an abnormal protein called TTR. It accumulates in the body, causing damage to the heart, nervous system, and gut. The first symptoms appear between 20 and 40 years old and are fatal within 10 years.
So this is a death sentence?
Pretty much so, yes.
Professor Ed Gain, New Zealand's leading liver specialist, was in charge of Aubrey Christmas's care.
He was intelligent, he was caring, he was incredibly strong, just put up with his disease from the time he first presented to me. He really had steady deterioration in his quality of life.
He was dizzy, he had severe fluid retention.
The last years can be brutal.
So when your heart is impacted, you can't pump, and your body can't get rid of the fluid, and so it stays in your system.
It became increasingly difficult for Aubrey to control his bowels.
It's not a dignified way to go at all. We have to wake up in the middle of the night because he's had an accident. And so you spend hours in the toilet because, you know, you have that sudden loose motions. So your wife is out there trying to change the sheets at 2:30 in the morning. So it's a lot.
And the impact on you?
Oh, gosh, I told you not to talk about it. Give me a minute.
Take your time.
As the end neared, Aubrey was admitted to Auckland Hospital with heart failure. Professor Ed Gain at his side.
And they just talked, and he held Aubrey's hand and looked him in the eyes, which I couldn't do, and tell him there's no going home from this.
I felt it had been a privilege to look after Aubrey, and he eventually died in here. And to be there with Aubrey's family was indeed a moving experience.
Aubrey Christmas was 57 years old.
These are my amazingly resilient four children.
his children now had to face a cold, hard fact.
Out of these four, how many will carry the gene for amyloidosis?
There's a high probability that any two of them could have it.
That's 50-50 odds. Aubrey and Jamie had always told their kids not to get gene tested.
And it's always been, no, just let them be. Let's let them live their life first. And then they can decide when they're older.
You would rather not know?
Without a cure, without a treatment, I would rather them not know.
Speaking to the younger members of the family who carry the mutation, but who are still well, it's important to give them hope. Up until now, we haven't had much hope.
Hope comes in all shapes and sizes. For hereditary amyloidosis, it arrived in a bag.
Oh, I'm so excited about this study. I think it has shown that for the first time, we may be able to cure this condition. So how are you feeling, Peter?
New Zealand is the first country to test on humans an extraordinary medical technology called CRISPR, which allows scientists to edit faulty genes in your DNA.
I think Auckland is really leading the world in terms of CRISPR gene editing. There are many centres who were to be involved throughout Europe, but most of those could not start at the time the study started 2 years ago because of the restrictions placed on them by the COVID pandemic in their countries.
CRISPR is short for clustered, regularly interspaced, short palindromic repeats.
Well, CRISPR is actually a natural process found in bacteria, which has evolved to protect them from viruses. Scientists a few years ago managed to adapt this to target precisely certain pieces of human DNA.
The gene editing treatment is delivered with fat particles through an intravenous solution. The particles bind to liver cells and find the gene that produces the abnormal TTR protein. Molecular scissors then cut out the faulty gene and the DNA naturally fuses back together. Once it's gone, the liver cells will no longer produce the abnormal TTR protein.
I was the second person in the world to have it, yeah. Just as we went into COVID lockdown in 2020.
Emma Watkinson inherited the abnormal amyloidosis gene.
That's my grandfather who had the amyloid as well. That was undiagnosed.
It's well through your family?
Yes, absolutely.
In the double skulls, New Zealand hung on grimly with...
It was passed on to her by her dad, Peter, a champion rower.
He did win a silver medal at the Perth and Commonwealth Games, and this is it.
Peter died last month with amyloidosis.
In the end, it was a terrible death, really. His heart not working properly, the heart failure because of the amyloid, and then the sort of cascading effect of his body just not circulating properly and not working properly.
It's a hell of a legacy, this, isn't it? Amyloidosis.
Yes, yeah.
CRISPR gene editing is a life-saving medical breakthrough, but some feel it leaves the door open for humans to play God.
Well, this specific case, I feel proud, actually.
A Chinese scientist was jailed for 3 years for gene editing the embryos of twins so they would be born immune to HIV.
What's your personal opinion? Should we be able to select for height or intelligence when we do gene editing?
No. I think this is a huge advance in medicine and it can fill unmet medical needs for people who have untreatable conditions. That's really where we should be using this new technology.
New Zealand has strict regulations and protocols around gene editing, but when Professor Ed Gane offered Emma Watkinson a place on the trial, she was initially reluctant.
I was apprehensive because it hadn't really been trialled on anybody before. I read, you know, pages and pages of documentation and I think what ultimately decided me to do it was for my own daughter, because if it works, then it works for her.
This is Molly, Emma's 12-year-old daughter.
So you have a 50-50 chance of carrying
it? Yes, a 50-50 chance. Yeah.
What do you think? Do you think you have it?
It's pretty random, but hopefully not.
What Emma didn't know as she started on the CRISPR trial is that the amyloid was already starting to stir in her body.
When I was screened, and that was a bit of an eye-opener for me, it was showing that the amyloid was starting to collect around my heart.
Professor Gane was hopeful, but nobody knew how successful this would be.
4 weeks after the injection has been given, we see around 90 to 95% reduction in the level of the abnormal protein. And that's maintained thereafter.
So that means Emma is highly unlikely to develop the symptoms of amyloidosis as she gets older.
Yes, indeed.
So 2 years on now, how do you feel?
I feel good, yeah.
What's it done to your mindset? Has it changed you at all?
Well, it's not sitting there inside you like this time bomb, you know? Yeah. And it is a relief to know that I'm not going to see the end of my life in the way that my father deteriorated.
Already, this is looking like a one-shot cure for other hereditary diseases that have ravaged generations of families that Ed Gane knew personally.
This seems miraculous, is it?
I think it is. Not only does it provide a potential cure for everyone living with hereditary amyloidosis, but it could also provide a cure for the tens of millions of people living with other inherited lethal diseases.
And how does it feel that if Molly does have this, that she can now be treated for it?
Well, that's just an amazing gift, really. When I first saw Ed Gane, he said to me, don't worry about your daughter. By the time that it becomes an issue for her, there'll be a cure. And in essence, he's right.
I think it's amazing that there's a cure for it. Like, it just seems so crazy that you can, that science is out there and that it's, you know, here in New Zealand and that people don't have to die from it anymore.
For years, Jamie Christmas told her children to live their lives and not to get tested for the disease that killed their father. CRISPR has flipped that equation.
It's a permanent fix to an otherwise futile, disastrous, devilish condition. And because of that hope, I mean, they're willing to be tested.
Hope comes in all shapes and sizes.
We can continue to live life, and they don't have to experience what Aubrey and I went through. Yeah, it's hope. It's hope.
Well, 12 New Zealanders have now been through the trial. It's hoped the treatments will be made available to the wider public within the next 5 years. Now, we heard the concerns of it leading essentially to designer humans. Head to our Facebook page to share your thoughts and to find more information.